So this is in continuation with what we have discussed in the last lecture. So this is, we call it lesson round number 3, part number 3 of the same lecture number 21. So you should notice that although we have tried to explain the nucleation rate, free energy and the critical undercooling required for, or the threshold undercooling required for nucleation, for both homogeneous and heterogeneous nucleation by using the same relationship. And this relationship is what we have derived is actually for homogeneous nucleation. Because that in case of heterogeneous nucleation, the N0 and then P, this constant will be different. So, and those things we have already discussed in the class, but I am not going into this all details, but nevertheless, the relationship for nucleation rate will be similar for both homogeneous and heterogeneous. Only these terms will be replaced by the appropriate value, like whether it is homogeneous or heterogeneous. But the other than, if you see the number of nucleus that form, the distribution remains same, but the different constants, their definition changes a little bit. So these things you please read the book. Today we will discuss more about the nucleation rate. Let us start with the homogeneous nucleation. So for homogeneous nucleation, what we wrote N star as N0 exp exponential of minus delta G star by KT and N D rotate some constant say P into exponential of minus delta G D diffusion related term by KT. So these parameters are known. Now suppose you have a liquid system and the atoms are free to move. There is no activation barrier. That means this term is not there. We are assuming hypothetical situation. It is not it is not possible. But if it happens, the nucleation rate will depend on these things. The moment you form a nucleus, critical nucleus, or the embryo of critical size, it will nucleate. So the rate will essentially be controlled by this equation. Now if you see this equation, how this equation, plot look like. So if we plot this exponential, you will see that say this is the plot of this say N star or ND. We'll plot both, like at the moment we are considering N star. N star, remember, this is the number of clusters and the liquid that have the critical size at a given temperature, say T, both. Now, see if the system, this is the melting point of the liquid, or the melting temperature of the liquid. So this is a temperature, like this, this is a temperature axis and this is rate or say number of cluster. So what happens, if you plot these things, this equation, you will get a variation of this kind. Now let us expand these equations. Then you will see that delta G star is related to 16 by 3 pi gamma SL Q by delta GV square, or we can write it 16 by 3 pi gamma SN U by LV square delta T square, and the numerator we will have Tm square. So now what happened, if your temperature, suppose if your temperature is closer to this melting temperature, so if T is almost closer to Tm, what will happen, delta T will be delta T will be almost 0. So if delta T is almost 0, delta G star will be infinite. Delta G star will be infinite. If delta G star goes to infinity, what will happen? This is exponential, negative. So 1 by infinity will become 0. So that is why at low undercooling, at very low undercooling, when it is close to melting point, then the nucleation rate or the number of flux that can be formed, it goes to 0. This is the axis. It means 0 cluster. Probably you will have no clusters having the size equal to or greater than the critical size. Now, if the undercooling is very high, that means you are dropping the temperature and you are coming very close to 0. So temperature is approaching to 0. What will happen? Look at this equation. If T goes to 0, it will become, this whole term will become infinity. If T goes to 0, 1 by say KT or say 1 by T will simply write 1 by T will tends to, it will approach infinity. So if it approaches to infinity, 1 by infinity, then N star will again approach to 0. So there also N star will, here also N star will approach to 0. So this is the other situation. That means if your undercooling is so high that you reach to the zero temperature, then also you will just a condition where probability of having a cluster of critical size is almost 0. That means you don't get any nuclei. Now say, okay, let us keep it for some more time. Now if you plot this ND, the ND, this, it is inversely proportional to, you see, this term is, what will happen if you increase T, if T increases, or say if T approaches to, let us take this condition, if T tends to 0, so now this is for ND, this two were for N star, now consider ND. If T approaches to 0, this term will become 1 by T will become infinity and then ND will become 0. But if you increase the T, what will happen? It will, if you increase the T, it will decrease as well. If as, because it is negative of exponential, it will increase. So what it does actually, it increases like this. So this is ND, this is N star, this is the number of side, and this is the number of atom which has got the activation energy for diffusion. So this number of atoms, so this probability increases. So now nucleation rate depends on both. So nucleation rate, say if we write capital N, say total nucleation rate, say let us write it here, some constant into N star into, we call it ND. So we wrote it constant into exponential of minus delta G star plus delta G D by KT. So overall behavior will be something, it will go like this and follow something like this. But you have to understand this shape is not so perfect here, but the physics is the physics remains the same. So what happened? If you see, so this is the overall nucleation rate, and the system will have. So this is diffusion. This term defines the diffusion. So what happened? If you see this behavior, it, as you go for higher undercooling, it initially increases and then it decreases again. Nucleation rate initially increases, again it decreases as you go for higher undercooling. That means your solidification temperature, if it is more and more down the compared to the melting point, initial it will increase and then it will decrease, and it reaches a maximum value at a particular temperature. This is called say critical temperature. So the critical temperature is the temperature at which the nucleation rate is maximum. This is the say N nucleation N max. At N max, T is called TC, critical nucleation, critical temperature. So what happens, you see, had this term been not there, this diffusion, the nucleation rate, the nucleation rate would have been somewhere here. The critical temperature would be less than this in presence, what we get in presence of this diffusion term. So what it does actually, the diffusion pushes this region up, and diffusion pushes the region up means the critical temperature at which you get the maximum nucleation rate, it goes up. That means with low amount of undercooling, you get the maximum diffusion rate. But the value of the maximum diffusion rate is, you see, reduced. That point you should remember. So this is how the diffusion comes into picture in the nucleation rate. So now I hope you have understood this part. So let us raise these things. Let us keep on with the final equation. So nucleation rate is what? Nucleation rate is number of nuclei, you know, that form per unit volume per unit time. Now you can have a liquid of finite volume. Now if you consider a liquid of unit volume, so if you consider unit volume of matter, say unit volume of matter. If you consider unit volume of matter, the reciprocal of the nucleation rate of the nucleation rate is nothing but the time. So time for nucleation. Thus you see what it tells you, the n versus, if you consider this term, this plot, this is the boundary. So maximum nucleation is this, but this is the nucleation rate at this, for a given temperature, this is the nucleation rate at this temperature, this will be the nucleation rate, this will be the nucleation rate, this will be the nucleation rate. So this plot, which is n versus t, if you just take the reciprocal of it, what you get is time, this will become time, n will become time, get temperature and then transformation curve. This is very interesting. You should note that how we get the time temperature transformation curve. Now if you know the cooling curve, you know at what rate you have to cool the system, at what temperature, to what temperature, and then hold it for how long to get a desired kind of microstructure. How these things are related, that we will discuss. But here you see this number of this nucleation rate. Now if you take the reciprocal of it, so the plot, so the TTT plot will be, let us really remove this thing. So the TTT plot will be something, the time temperature transformation plot will be something, the reciprocal is like the reciprocal. Temperature remains the same, T, here the it is time. So you get a curve something like this. So this is the same melting point, Tm. let us write it here, say temperature. So this is the TM, melting point, or the transformation temperature. It will depend on material. Now you will get a cup, something like this. So this point, this is the time. Now here, this is small t. Call it small t. What's the time? Small t time. This is temperature. T is the temperature. So what it tells you that suppose you have a material at this temperature, above melting point, so it will be liquid. Now, if you want to get a solid, what rate, how long it takes to nucleate the solid? Suppose if you are cooling in this way, this is the rate, time, temperature versus time. So after this, at this point, after you spend this much of time, you will get this solid phase. So, the initiation of this solid in the liquid. So this boundary tells you the starting point. The starting point of nucleation. Now there will be actually a similar plot as you see in TTT diagram, where all the liquid will be converted into solid. So if you hold it for long time, all the liquid will be converted into solid, and this will be then called, this line will be called finishing time. So this equation, nucleation rate, tells you only the starting time. That means how long you have to, how, what time it takes to start the nucleation. Of course you need time, because the atom is to come together, otherwise it will not be nucleated. Now suppose if you don't intersect this curve, if your cooling rate is very high, if you go something like this, so that means your time, you have not given sufficient time to the liquid to nucleate into solid. So in this region, what you get, you end up getting an amorphous metal. This is called glass. So this is, if it is a metal, if your cooling rate is very high, then actually you are not giving enough time for the system to nucleate. Actually this cooling, because of cooling rate, so you end up getting amorphous materials. So these things are very, very interesting. As you can see, this maximum nucleation rate is inversely proportional to 1 by T minimum. So this time is actually, this is the starting, this is the minimum time. Time minimum that you need to provide for nucleation of a particular phase. And this is the reason that you see in heat treatment, if you study, you will study that for different cooling rate, you end up getting different phases, because nucleation of different phases depends on the time that you are giving. So if you are cooling it very fast, you are not giving sufficient time, it will be one phase. If you are giving sufficient time, maybe you will end up getting another phase. So these things are very interesting to know. So I hope you have understood this part, what we have discussed very simply, in a very simple manner. So next we will discuss, so this is the minimum time, just one thing, this is the, again, the critical temperature, this is the most steep. So next class, we will discuss about the TTT diagram of, say, some iron thermal steel.